Hello everyone, just me, Jeff Donnelly, JP Donnelly, jpdonnelly8.com, jpdonnelly8 YouTube, and jpdonnelly8 a bunch of other places, such as Instagram. Okay, so let's talk about a little situation, right? So last week or so, as you guys are aware, I got a copy of the recordings for the Springfield case, Springfield gun license issue case for the appeal. Took them about a month or so to give me all the recordings. So now, excuse me, comes time for the transcripts. So I put in for the transcripts, and I misplaced the paperwork that the court gave me after I filed the motion for the court to pay for the transcripts to be provided and for the recordings and everything else. So what I did is they transferred me to a transcript person in Maryland. So, you know, I contacted them, said, okay, well, the court has the information, has the documents, you know, saying that the Commonwealth is paying for the transcripts. And I asked them if they could reach out to them to be provided with the information. So, a little bit back and forth, So yesterday, what ends up being found out is that the court, Massachusetts, district court or whatever, is saying that I was never, approved for the Commonwealth to pick up the tab for the transcript cost. And remember, these transcripts aren't free. They're not cheap. They cost about $3,000, $3,000 for these transcripts to be made for this, that are needed for the appeal. Okay, so, what happens? I contacted the state, and the state's telling me, oh, no. We don't have anything in the file saying that the state's paying for this. You're paying for this. I'm like, no, the paperwork exists. They told me, we went through the paperwork, went through the documents and everything else, and it doesn't exist. It was never approved. I'm like, yeah, it was. So then I end up going down to the court. Well, first off, I call the court, Springfield District Court. And what do they tell me? Once more, they tell me, it's not in the file. Neither is your appeal. I'm like, what do you mean? My notice of appeal is not in the file, nor is the approval for the waiver of costs. They're like, yep. So I drive down there figuring, God damn it, I'm going to have to go before a judge again and have it all approved again, because they're deleting the information again from the file. I go through the file, and sure enough, I find my notice of appeal is still in the file. Don't know if it got put back in there, by someone or not, because they said it wasn't there in the beginning. And then I find the other paperwork. It's in the file. Okay. I have them make a few copies of it. I take some screenshots, email it out to the person with the court and also the person down in Maryland who's going to be doing the transcripts. So, the person doing the transcripts, because the person from the state told me that my request was going to be canceled and I was going to have to refile for the transcripts and everything else, which obviously would add more time to that in order to get it processed and everything else. So right now, as it stands, I should be getting the transcripts very late in August. It really sucks because I can't put in the brief, because I can't draft the brief until I actually get the transcripts in order to draft the brief from what's stated on the transcripts. But it seems like it should be a cut and dry case if this goes to Massachusetts Supreme Judicial Court or even the appeals court. I'm trying to do a direct appeal to the Massachusetts Supreme Judicial Court because, obvious reasons. It's constitutional issues and everything else, and I'd rather see the highest court in Massachusetts handle this than the appeals court. So, yeah. Should take a while to get the copies of the transcripts, but I do plan on posting some more video, some more audios from the hearings. So at least you guys see exactly what the hell went down and how corrupt this shit is. So once again, any donations can be sent to my P.O. box, you know, which is listed down below. It could be, you know, sent through PayPal at jpdonnelly8@aol.com. Any questions that you may have can be sent to jpdonnelly8@aol.com, and I'll answer anything that you guys ask, for the most part. You know, if you guys are just being a dick, I'm not gonna, obviously, yeah. You know how that is. Okay, so, oh yeah, once again, Jeff Donnelly, a former political candidate, holder of a bachelor's degree in psychology, double associates in criminal justice, most of fine arts slash art education degree, former, I was employed by the Massachusetts Department of Youth Services for a while. I was with the Springfield Park Rangers, which is now a defunct law enforcement agency, but it was a pristine law enforcement agency at one point in time when I was there. Yeah, so have a great day.